Hi and welcome. In this tutorial, you will learn how to create a scrollable text area with the Scroll Rect and TextMeshPro. For this, I have prepared a lengthy Wikipedia-style text and some background art. You currently see the result we are going to create. No coding needed for this one. First, create a new scroll view and resize it as you need. You can also set up the background graphic for your text box here. If your text is just a standard one, which will be red top to bottom, get rid of the horizontal scroll bar and toggle off horizontal in the settings. We will deal with this in a moment. On the Content Gameobject, create a new TextMeshPro UI component. You can also just create a new TextMeshPro object, in which case you need to link it up manually here. I'll call it Content going forward. Let's see how this looks inside the game. Well, our text only moves a tiny bit and snaps back. The reason for this is that your text box, or your content, is too small. You can see it in the editor view being surrounded by a yellow border. Let's start fixing this. First, resize content to fit its parent game object's size. Hold Alt, click here. Make sure your pivot position Y is set to 1 to have your text be displayed correctly. If this is set to 0.5, your scroll view will start in the middle of your content. A value of 0 will start your text at the bottom. Now our text box has the same height as a parent, but it actually won't help in being scrollable. So add a content size fitter component and set its vertical fit to preferred size. Your text is scrollable now already, yay! But let's take a moment to work on some details. Your text is probably smooshed right up to the sides of your text box graphic. To fix it, open the extra settings on your TMP component and enter your desired values into the margins. The vertical scroll bar isn't continued to reach the bottom of your box anymore because that's where the horizontal scroll area had been located. Select it and resize it by alt-clicking this button here. Sometimes it needs a few more clicks to work correctly. And lastly, if your text box is any other shape than a straight up rectangle, to have the scroll bar take on the shape of your text box and not stick out at the top or bottom, we need our parent object to have a mask as an image component, just like our viewport. If you came here and watched my pagination tutorial before, you might also have come across scroll rect inside the overflow settings of TMP. It seems to be a wholly decorative settings in this dropdown, with no real functionality behind it. If you got it to work, please comment and tell us how. I hope this tutorial was useful to you. If you liked it, please like and subscribe. If you'd like to learn more about TextMeshPro, I have a whole playlist of videos on the topic, and if you'd like to know how to add tooltip pop-ups to your text boxes, I recommend watching this tutorial. Have a great week!